couple months ago, it was reported that the Northern California estate of the late beloved comedian Robin Williams was still in the market. He lived in this desirable Paradise Cay mansion for 6 years, and it offers amazing views of San Francisco. Although he's sadly no longer with us, Mr. Williams had quite the taste in real estate and called some beautiful properties home over the years. Today, we'll take a look at his previous mansions in San Francisco, Napa Valley, and more. We even found some of the listings. Robin McLaurin Williams was an American actor and comedian known for his improv skills, a wide variety of memorable voices, and often regarded as one of the best comedians of all time. He began performing stand-up in San Francisco and LA way back in the 1970s, and clearly still loved those California cities because he lived there until his death. Robin rose to fame for playing the alien Mork in the sitcom Mork and Mindy from 1978 to 1982. After Robin's first starring film role in Popeye, he went on to be in several critically and commercially successful films like Good Morning Vietnam, Dead Poets Society, and Patch Adams, just to name a few. He also starred in box office hits including Mrs. Doubtfire, Jumanji, the original one that is, and Aladdin. Not to mention, Robin was nominated for 4 Academy Awards, winning Best Supporting Actor for the movie Good Will Hunting in 1997, and that's just one of his many awards. Over the span of his career, Mr. Williams accumulated an estimated net worth of around $100 million, and his wealth also included his impressive real estate portfolio and several investments. Sadly, Robin shocked the world in 2014 at the age of 63 when he took his own life at his home in Paradise Cay. Although nobody expected to hear such devastating news, the actor was struggling with Lewy body disease, which causes changes with thinking, body movement, behavior, mood, and dementia. In the months before his passing, Robin was besieged by paranoia and so confused he couldn't remember lines while filming anymore. For nearly a year, the comedian tried different medications, therapies, tests, and alternative treatments like yoga, but ultimately nothing helped. His widow, Susan Schneider Williams, said, "He kept saying, 'I just want to reboot my brain.'" Today, we'll look at some of the legacy that Robin Williams left behind in the form of his beautiful and well-kept homes. Hey guys, it's Kara here for you on Famous Entertainment, and today we're gonna take a look at 3 properties of the late and great comedian slash actor extraordinaire Robin Williams. And believe me, his homes are just as impressive as you'd expect. If you like these videos, make sure you're subscribed and ring that bell for notifications. We've also done house tours on legends such as Elvis Presley and Michael Jackson, and we'll link to some at the end. Follow me on Instagram to chat, and as usual, let me know whose house tour is next in those comments down below. Now let's get into this video. First, just as a warm-up, let's take a quick look at a more modestly sized house Robin used to own once upon a time. In April 2014, months before his passing, it was reported that he quietly sold this house in Bronson Canyon to a non-celebrity for $869,000. Robin bought the home in 2009 for just over $857,000, according to records, and it's a modest abode in the leafy and historic neighborhood of Bronson Canyon, Los Angeles. It's not confirmed that he and his wife ever lived here. It's also possible it was purchased for one of his kids. Either way, the home appeared to be a storybook Tudor style build, retaining many of its original architectural features from when it was built in the 1920s. The humble space spanned just 1,318 square feet inside, with 2 beds and 1.5 baths, plus what the listing called a unique screening room, but I'll get to that in a sec. An arched front door opens to a tiny entryway and leads to a living room with original wood floors, raised and angled ceilings, and a period fireplace. Multi-pane French doors at the far end of the room lead to the home's primary outdoor space, a walled and shaded red brick terrace. In the dining room, there are built-in bookcases and a wall of windows, while next door there's a kitchen. A slim staircase leads to the upper level, where you'll find the 2 bedrooms, one with a vaulted ceiling. And that unique screening room I mentioned, it's basically a room with a carpeted platform consuming most of the floor space, inviting you to crawl up onto it and onto a daybed facing the TV screen. Here's a photo because I truly don't get it. Considering the size of that house, I have trouble believing Mr. Williams himself ever actually lived in it. Like I said, it was probably bought for a family member, so let's move on to a place he did actually live. In 2016, after his passing and after several years on and off the market, Robin's mega estate in Napa Valley was finally sold for $18.1 million, which was actually a steep discount. It was reported prior to his death that he already was listing the property, so it was a long time coming. This 650 plus acre vineyard was situated located about 80 miles from the Golden Gate Bridge in the Mayacamas Mountains, straddling a county line, so it's technically in both Napa and Sonoma Valley. Mr. Williams originally listed the massive property in summer 2012 for $35 million, but it was taken off the market and relisted, so you can see that the $18 million sale was a huge price cut. The large spread that Robin and his family used to enjoy was dubbed Villa Sonrisa, or House of Smiles, and was anchored by a grand Italian-style villa spanning about 20,000 square feet. Inside, there were 5 beds, 5 full and 5 half baths across a triple-story mansion, which combined luxurious but comfortable living and entertaining spaces. There was a grand entryway and winding staircase, an elegant living room with fireplace, and a formal dining room just next door. Other spaces included an oak-paneled library with built-in bookcases, a family room, and a contemporary country kitchen with a walkout terrace. The movie theater here was actually what you'd expect, not like that last house, and had seats for 12 or more guests. Other features of Robin's previous Napa estate included an elevator that serviced all 3 floors, a games room, climate-controlled cellars for wine and art storage, and for the security-minded, there were not one but 3 safe rooms. Elsewhere, you'll find a tower room that could be accessed by bridge and offered wraparound mountain, valley, and vineyard views. I think that would be my fave place in this mansion for sure. The main floor of the residence opens to a house-wide terrace with staircases leading down to a 65-foot infinity pool and oversized spa. The mansion-sized property also offers a detached 3,200 square foot guest house, a horse barn, tennis court, sculpture gardens, olive grove, spring-fed pond, and over 18 acres of vineyards. With over 650 acres, of course, the spread even has its own hiking and riding trails. I mean, it sounds like more of a kingdom than a single family home. Although that Napa estate was gigantic and crazy impressive, so was the most recent home that Robin and his wife lived in. Sadly, this is the estate where he passed and spent his final days as well, and it's still on the market. Clearly, Mr. Williams was a fan of Northern California, and he bought this hilltop mansion with sweeping views of San Francisco Bay in 2008 for just over $4 million. It was located in the exclusive Paradise Cay community just north of San Francisco. This neighborhood is surrounded by the town of Tiburon, which has easy access into the heart of the city via the highway or the numerous ferries that take both residents and visitors back and forth across the bay. Robin's home was first put on the market in late 2019 for $7.25 million, but this year the price has dropped to about $5.9 million. This single-level home occupies a double-wide lot and boasts water views to the Golden Gate Bridge and the bay, even from inside the home thanks to floor-to-ceiling windows. His previous residence was a contemporary Mediterranean-style villa with just over 6,500 square feet, 6 beds, and 6.5 baths. The home had gorgeous open-plan living spaces throughout and glass sliders to seamlessly flow the indoor and outdoor areas, and so you never lose those water views. The residence was built in 1987 but underwent a major remodel in 2000. There was a spacious eat-in kitchen, dining and family rooms, a wood-paneled library with fireplace, and the master bath had views to the bay right from the tub. Walk to the rear of the home and you even have direct access to the bay. There's a waterfront deck with outdoor dining and lounge areas, a designer pool and spa, and surrounding stone patio. Although one may assume the home is still on the market because it was the site of Mr. Williams' death, experts say it's more likely because the celebrity-worthy residence is too unaffordable right now for the average buyer. And with the location and beauty of the home, I can see why. Alright, that's all I got for the beautiful mansions of the late Robin Williams. After seeing where the legendary comedian used to call home, what did you guys think? If you had to choose, which of those 3 houses would you live in? I think I'd pick that Napa Valley estate. I'd even just live in that gorgeous tower. Comment your choice down below. Also, give my personal channel a follow and check out my latest fit.
Oh, you might be one of the guys.
Oh no, I'm gonna be Joey.
Hey, Ken Adams. Nice to meet you.
Regina Phalange.
So, we'll see how true it is.
Alright, so let's have you go first and then I'll make sure you don't cheat.
Thanks for tuning in. Follow me on Instagram to chat and let me know whose house tour you guys want to see next. I'll see you all in the next video. Bye!